Okay, now we move on to exercise 11B, getting to know ArcGIS Desktop 4903. And this begins on page 294 of your book. And this exercise will be continuing from the previous map, and we'll be adding a graph. I'm not sure how you can add graphs to maps, it's very handy. This is the exact same, map that you made last time. The only difference is that it has been classified by attributes, so by different ECIDs, now have different colors. Okay, so the question is, how do you create a graph? Well, it's a graph, I suppose. You just go to the tools menu, graphs, and then create. And you can choose between the different types of graphs that you want. You want to do a vertical bar for our purposes. And again, at least this should be the only choice, since the only field is open. And the standard value that we want to show is the sum. The sum of the standard values, which is statistics we used before. That looks about right. X label fields. It should be the lease ID. There we are. And maybe if we want it added to legend. We go on to the next. You can change the name quite easily. The name that we've chosen is the least values. You just want to enter that in the title. And the footer, because you want to be descriptive about what this unit is in. Millions of dollars, $80, all this is since it's not Canada. And again, you want the graph legend. If you don't want it three-dimensional, you don't want access properties on there. Because we already know it's millions of dollars, and also this is not necessary. Just makes it cleaner. Go ahead and click finish. And you'll see now the we have the floating lease values and the floating graph. And this is, you know, exactly what we want, except we also want to be able to see it in the layout view. Because it's still, you can see it, but it's not in the layout itself. And how do you do that? Well, you right click on the lease values and you click add to layout. And now, again, we're automatically in the layout view, and it's added to the layout. Go ahead and put it in the upper right-hand side. You can resize it if you want. Only need to make sure that if you resize it, sometimes the values of the axis can change. So you just make sure that you are happy with what you have. And again, when you added the graph, it automatically added the labels. Okay, well that's it for 11B. Go ahead and save your work and move on to exercise 11C.